Update 2 on Typhoon Dolphin, which has intensified slightly since the last update. Winds now 110 miles per hour and a pressure of 952 millibars, moving west-northwest to 15 miles per hour. Its position's 12.5 degrees north, 149.7 degrees east. The storm's expected to continue in this vein and move towards the west-northwest. It looks as though it will move just to the north of Guam, possibly affecting Rota directly now, and it looks as though the storm will make landfall or possible landfall pass through those islands as a high-end Category 2 storm, or indeed possibly a Category 3. After that, it will intensify further by the looks of things, and by 2 or 3 days from now, it could be possibly knocking on the door of becoming a super typhoon. It will then move off towards the northeast and affect some of the Japanese islands as it moves towards the northeast as a Category 3 storm. Right now, though, a typhoon warning is in effect for Guam and Rota, the island to the north of Guam. We also have a typhoon watch and a tropical storm warning in effect for Tinian and Saipan, further north in the Mariana Islands. That's as of May the 14th at 1 p.m. UTC. No other warnings in effect anywhere else, but we could possibly see typhoon conditions on Guam and Rota in particular. That's where we are most concerned about. Sea surface temperatures are fairly warm, around 28 degrees Celsius or so, perhaps even higher than that, maybe, especially as it moves towards those islands, which will certainly provide the storm with fuel to possibly intensify further. But does wind shear help it out any? Possibly not, because it is increasing to the east, to the west of the storm, and is increasing slightly where the storm is located right now, though it is lower to the west of the Mariana Islands. And this is what it looks like on the water vapor imagery right now as well. You can see dry air over the towards the west there as well, by the looks of things. So that may also impede its progress, and probably has done in the past day or two. Here's the latest satellite imagery. So nothing obvious to suggest that this is bordering on a Category 3 storm. The eye is not clearly visible, but it is there somewhere by the looks of things, I would say. And as far as the islands are concerned, the dry air is leaving the area, so the storm is coming in behind it, obviously, and is affecting those islands, or will be affecting those islands very soon with the first real rain bands and thunderstorms. The central core of the storm may pass over those islands of Guam and Rota. As of May the 14th at 2 p.m. UTC, there isn't that much going on. There is this, of course, Typhoon Dolphin. Invest 92A dissipated not so long ago near India. We also have two invests, Invest 99P and 95W in the Pacific as well, 99P in the south. 29 tropical storms have formed so far in 2015 around the world. 18 have gone on to become Category 1 hurricanes with winds of 74 miles per hour or higher. Of course, Dolphin was number 18. And 11 have gone on to become Category 3 storms with winds of 115 miles per hour or higher. And may have a good shot becoming number 12. You can follow Force 13 on any of our outlets. The website, force13.com, is under renovation at this point. Hopefully it will be online in a new format very soon indeed. You can also follow us on YouTube, Facebook and Twitter. Search Force 13 on any of those. The Facebook page is run by 5 of our team members, so you're in good hands there. You can also add me on Skype, at Fool13, for tropical weather chat on there, and to get involved in the chat room on there as well, where you can discuss the current situation with fellow storm trackers. We may also be on air later this evening. Look out for the link to the event on our social media pages in particular, and that will hopefully tell you when it will be. That's all for now.